everyone, and welcome back to another AAC video. For those coming across the Animal Artist Collective for the first time, we are a group of artists here on YouTube that create artwork every other month in order to raise awareness and donation funds for various conservation initiatives around the world. In 2018, those of you who purchased original artwork from our AAC artists not only helped to support working artists, but also contributed $1,795 to 20 different nonprofit organizations around the globe. So for that, I just want to take a quick moment to say thank you for your support. It is 2019, and with a new year comes a new overarching theme for our AAC videos. In 2018, we focused on covering a wide range of various habitats, and this year we're going to be aiming our sights at exploring different animal groups. Many of you voted back in November and determined that we'd kick off this new year with a lesser romanticized group of animals, insects. For those of you who have been around my channel or Instagram for long, you might already be able to guess the animal that I wanted to choose for this theme, because I absolutely love the TV show Firefly. I also met my first firefly ever in real life in 2018, so it was fresh in my mind. However, one of our other artists really wanted to go ahead and do that animal, so you can head on over to Melanie's channel to see her lovely piece on them. My second thought was that, well, if I didn't cover crickets, I might have some disappointed fans that would have loved for me to capitalize on the pun given my kitty's name. However, ultimately, I had to tap back into my educator roots and pull out a lesser-loved species that I absolutely adore that deserves heaps more of attention given how important they are to their ecosystems. Yes, friends, I picked cockroaches, and more specifically, the Madagascar hissing cockroach. Hear me out, though, because they are seriously awesome animals. To start things off in opening our hearts to accepting some new little creepy crawlers, I wanted to share the fact that there are about 4,600 cockroach species in the world. Only 30 or so of those are found in human habitats, and about 4 or 5 are considered widespread common pests. So while a fraction of a percent of the species of cockroaches that exist are considered pests, the rest are all getting a very unfair and bad rap due to sharing a similar name. The majority of cockroach species, including the Madagascar hissing cockroaches, can be found in the tropics and subtropic regions of the world. However, they can be found on every continent in nearly every habitat. While most species are around the size of a thumbnail, the largest cockroach in the world, no surprise, comes from Australia, is the giant burrowing cockroach. It clocks in at about 3.5 inches long. While not quite as large, the Madagascar hissing cockroaches is still among the biggest in the world at a respectable 2.5 to 3 inches long at adulthood. The hissing cockroaches, or MHCs as I'll start calling them, like other insects, have 3 body parts. They have a head, a thorax, and an abdomen, as well as 6 legs and 2 antennae. It's hard to identify all 3 body parts from a top-down view of these cockroaches, as their heads are safely tucked underneath their pronotum, which is a specialized portion of their thorax. This species does not have wings, and they are sexually dimorphic, meaning that the males and females look different from one another. The males are usually identified by their pronounced bump or horn-like structures that are on top of their pronotums, which are used for fighting other males. Yes, folks, these cockroaches fight for dominance in their little family groups, and although I'm sure they would not appreciate me saying so, I got to see it once in person, and it's pretty darn adorable. It's hard to explain without visuals, but imagine I'm holding my index fingers tip to tip, or as we're imagining them as cockroaches, head to head, and the males push back and forth and just kind of do this slowly for several minutes. After one of them gives in, the other one is declared the winner and gets all the girlfriends. As their name suggests, the Madagascar hissing cockroaches are found in Madagascar, and more specifically on the forest floors, where they have an extremely important job as decomposers. While most species of cockroach are omnivorous, hissing cockroaches specialize in eating decaying plant material. In the rainforest, it's crucial that the fallen plant material that falls to the ground is returned to the soil as nutrients, and these cockroaches are the ones who do that. They eat things like decaying leaves and fruit, so by the time it goes through their digestive tracts, it comes out the other end as soil, thus helping to replant the entire forest and keeping everything else healthy and growing. In order for themselves to keep clean amongst the forest floor, they actually have formed a symbiotic or beneficial relationship with a very specific species of mite. This species of mite can only survive on this species of cockroach, and in return for shelter and an endless food supply, the cockroaches are kept constantly clean from the decaying plant matter around them and even potentially dangerous mold spores that might fall onto their exoskeletons. Also, as their name suggests, hissing cockroaches are able to make a hissing noise. This is obviously not produced by blowing air over their non-existent tongues like we as humans would, but instead forcing air out through tiny holes called spiracles that line the edges of their abdomen. Spiracles are generally used by cockroaches for breathing, but in this gregarious species, they can also be used for communication, like saying, "Hey, back off," or "How about a date, pretty lady?" For our last little round of factoids here, I wanted to share some cool information on how they reproduce. Female hissing cockroaches form approximately 50 eggs inside of a long case called an ootheca inside of their body. The ootheca is extruded from the female's abdomen, externally fertilized by the male, and then retracted back into the female's body until she is ready to give birth to live young. At birth, the babies look like little tiny rice-like aliens, and I won't share an image here of the ootheca or the babies in case some of you are squeamish, but it's pretty cool, so if you're interested, go ahead and look it up on Google Images. It's pretty awesome. As the babies grow, they will go through many molts, shedding their exoskeleton until they reach maturity. After each molt, they will be white in color, just like they were at birth, and very vulnerable to predation. However, after a couple of days, the new exoskeleton hardens and darkens so that they can once again camouflage into the forest floor. The individuals in the species can live a whopping 2 to 5 years, which might be longer than a lot of people expect insects to live. Cockroaches in some form or another date back to around 320 million years ago in the fossil record, meaning they have survived 3 mass extinctions, and they're amidst their 4th one that is currently happening right now. Madagascar, as I'm sure many of you know, is under threat of deforestation. Understandably, many other cuter species like lemurs serve as the flagship animals at the forefront of Malagasy conservation, but hundreds of other species exist on the island that are relying on us to help save them as well. To that end, 50% of the proceeds from the sale of this original artwork will be donated to the Madagascar Fauna and Flora Group, which has been striving to preserve biodiversity in Madagascar for over 30 years. You can find links to this artwork piece as well as that organization in the description below if you'd like to go ahead and help out. So finally, coming back around to this art piece, obviously I knew that I was picking a lesser appreciated species, so I definitely wanted to do my best to make them look as cute as possible for the best chance of being able to raise funds for this cause. With Valentine's Day coming up next month, I thought it would be kind of cute to do a little love bug theme, so here I made a literal couple of roaches. The female is on the left while the male is on the right, distinguishable, of course, by those little horns. I decided to go for a more illustrative style and use a plastic nibbed micron pen to ink the outline of my drawing, something that's pretty atypical for me, but I felt it was important to the look of this piece. I ended up getting this pen from my sister, so thank you, Jenny, and I really love the way it handles, though I do want to note that it rubbed off when I erased my pencil work, so I had to reapply the lines before painting. I decided to use some of my favorite transparent watercolors to color this piece. I used Daniel Smith's Quinacridone Gold and Permanent Brown, as well as M. Graham's Purple Leaning Neutral Tint. Towards the end, I also used some raw umber violet to tie things together a bit more and added a touch of Quinacridone Pink to the Permanent Brown to make the color for the hearts. I did take a little bit of artistic liberty with the antennas on this piece. For those of you who might know this species well, their actual antennas in real life taper to a point, and they're a bit fluffier at the base of them, especially on the males, but for this specific piece, I wanted them to look as approachable as possible, so I did kind of those cute cartoony bulbous style antennas instead. I did include one more real anatomical feature, though, that I forgot to mention earlier during our cockroach facts, and that's that they have these little hooks on their legs. While hissing cockroaches live primarily on the forest floor, they may occasionally have to crawl over some fallen trees or whatnot, so their legs come equipped with these little spikes that help them to hold on to various surfaces. They're so effective, in fact, that they can actually cling to vertical glass or even hang upside down on more grippy type surfaces, which I've always just thought is really cool. Today, I'm going to leave you all with one of my favorite zoo pictures, and that is one of me and the largest Madagascar hissing cockroaches I had ever met. It was at a special zoo event I was working at, actually a fancy Valentine's Day dinner, where I got to share unique animal mating behaviors with couples and convince them that cockroaches are worth a second look. I do hope that you guys walk away from this video feeling the same way, and I hope that you'll go check out some of the other AAC videos to learn about some other really cool insects. All of the participating artists for this round can be found in the description below this video. You can also head on over to our Facebook page and vote on the next round's theme between birds and reptiles. Regardless of the outcome, I am super stoked for the next round, and I hope that you guys are too. Thank you guys all so much for watching. Be sure to let me know some of your favorite insects in the comments below, or let me know one of your favorite things that you learned in today's video. A special thanks to my patrons who help keep this channel afloat, and I will see you next time.